Right now, investigators can't say whether the body is that of the missing woman. West 2's Claire Madz is at the scene in Edgewater working the very latest. Claire, what do you know?
Yeah, Martha, we're on Needle Palm, which is actually a street behind Mango Tree, which is where the missing woman lives. But we're on this street because the home behind me belongs to a Volusia County Sheriff's deputy. And it was he who smelt something terrible today, went to investigate in a wooded lot between his and the missing woman's home and uncovered a body, immediately called Edgewater Police. Take a look at 61-year-old Shirley Weller. This is a picture of her. And coincidentally, we were out here today, called out here by Edgewater PD to do a story about this missing woman. She hasn't been seen since last Tuesday when colleagues at the University of Central Florida in Daytona Beach called and said she hadn't shown up for work. So investigators went out to the home and they have been searching for her ever since. She is married to an 81-year-old man, very elderly man, and he just really isn't quite aware of what's going on right now. So there was great concern that this 61-year-old woman just disappeared mysteriously. Take a look at video today as we were here shooting pictures for our story about this missing endangered woman. Suddenly, all the police show up and start putting crime tape up around the scene, and then we learned that there was a body found. Whether or not it is this missing woman, we just can't say for sure. An autopsy will be performed tomorrow. Matter of fact, the ME is on scene right now. We do know that the body that was found is very badly decomposed, and again, the woman, Shirley Weller, who has been missing for a week, could very well be this person. It certainly would hold with the decomposition of the body. Again, unclear as to cause of death. Investigators are working very hard to find out. But if, in fact, it is this missing woman, a very sad ending to this story. Reporting live in Edgewater, Volusia County, Claire Metz, West 2 News.